This is the second control room of Government Institute of Medical Sciences, from where the doctors are coordinating with all the patients who are admitted inside the hospital and also with those who are in the home isolation. So we have with us Dr. Rahul. Dr. Rahul, please tell us, how do you coordinate the patient who are in home isolation as well as who are admitted in the hospital?
Currently, we are here at GIMS. GIMS is Government Institute of Medical Sciences, Greater Noida. This is the isolation control room. Once we receive our patient, we segregate the patient as per the severity. If the patient is really severe and the symptoms are really high, in that case, the patient goes to a different ward. In cases where patients do not have very high symptoms, they are kept into a separate ward. We have male and female separate ward. Here in the system, we'll tell you, like, you know, there are different wards and how do we monitor it. Like, this is probably the nursing station. From here, we have a PA system. We have worked a lot on the communication. Communication has been really one of the most powerful tools that we have used in GIMS. We have a WhatsApp group where we make sure that every patient is a part of it. That is called Heroes Group. The patient can directly write their problem, and there's a system that we address the problem in next 10 minutes. If at all you're not able to solve, if the patient is not receiving the solution in 10 minutes, you can directly call up the director. So that has been a very a unique way of addressing problem. The second is probably a PA system. For example, I'll just show it to you. Here is the main nursing station here. If at all I have to announce here that this particular gentleman or the nursing station should reach to a particular ward. For example, nursing staff on third floor. Nursing staff on third floor, please reach C2 ward. C2 ward.
They'll just start working from the main administration area to the...
Require a lot of manpower from one place to another. Nursing staff, please go to C2 ward. C2 ward, right? So in the minimum time, we have to give the maximum output. So that is how we make use of every technology that we can use to make the patient care very easy, accessible and friendly. So that is our strength.
So in any kind of emergency situation, the action can be taken very easily, and for the patient who are in home isolation, there's a WhatsApp group that works continuously 24 hours, and if patients have queries, they can ask them on that WhatsApp group. Here is a set of doctors who are sitting here. So anything you suggest to your patients who are in home isolation regarding the mental health part?
First of all, we'd just like to tell all patients that not to be scared of the disease. Take all the necessary precautions, be careful, isolate yourselves if you are having symptoms or coming positive, but not to get scared of the disease and actually try and beat it. And secondly, regarding the mental health, there's always people you can reach out to. From our side, what we do, all our patients that are going for home isolation, we are calling them on a daily basis for about 7 to 10 days and following up as to how they are feeling and if they are having any complaints, whether physical or mental. They can always let us know and we can guide them how further. Apart from that, there are always daily activities that you can do, like listening to a little bit of calming music or something that gives you happiness to reduce your anxiety and stay a little calm.
So here, the set of doctors who are on the line to take action, those who are in the home isolation part. So there's a WhatsApp group that works 24 hours. Secondly, they check the patient throughout the 10 days in the home isolation. And thirdly, they suggest to be calm at every point in the home isolation, because mental health is very important. We don't have to be panicked. We don't have to scared. We have to fight COVID-19 strongly. With video journalist Himanshu Mishra, Shrutika, Noida, for India Today.